By going to the stream.
I'm okay.
Yeah, okay. You don't have to follow in that closely after all. It is just pipe dream at the moment. If you would give me a god dang piece that I could use, game. Oh my.
Oh dear. As you notice that there's actually like three pipes being loaded in there at once.
Yeah, the...
Oh. Ah.
Oh good, oh good, oh joy, oh good, oh good, oh good, oh good, oh good, oh good. Fudge you! Fudge you!
Sorry, I can't help myself.
Okay, I just need one more long piece. That. Okay, no, okay, fine. I'll just have to do it the other way then, which I think we can do. Yes, we can. There we go! I hate pipe dream! By the way, it just spoke fake, fake Spanish at us. You know, very, very racist Spanish. And then just finished it off with Señor, the vending machine for guns, because it's supposed to be El Chapo or something that's selling you the guns. The joke. It's purposely supposed to be racist because that's the joke. Which is only funny so many times. It's why, for example, Cards Against Humanity is only funny so many times. Where is the... There's the drone.
I disagree with that statement, but then again, I basically have the mentality of a 2-year-old.
What?
I disagree with the fact that Cards Against Humanity is only funny a certain amount of times. I think it's hilarious every time.
It more depends on, I guess, just the everyone's mood at the time more. That and just the certain people you get around you.
Yeah, it's a combination of who's around you and also not immediately just resorting to racism. Because racism is the lowest common denominator, which can be funny in of its own right, but... But sometimes it's just, you know, not that.
I know. So how are they able to make flying turrets in 1940? Yeah, but how are they able to make them automatic?
Well, that's easy. Sandra Cohen hired the best person that he could for the job. You know? And when he couldn't get the best person for the job, the man that he thought invented the light bulb, he hired his assistant, Nikola Tesla. And he had many questions about this Tesla man, but when it turns out this Tesla person was better at basically everything and was actually... the actual inventor of the light bulb. Oh god. Oh god, there's the spider's place. There we go. Wow, those spider splicers die immediately to anti-infantry bullets.
Probably because they have no armor.
Yeah, they're humans. It turns out bullets are really effective against people.
Well, that's quite the dignifying shot.
Exactly. But yeah, it's a context thing. For example, I would never play Cards Against Humanity with Caleb. Because it wouldn't really be very fun for him. Because he appreciates the humor of it, but... Oh, great, there's a turret right there. Okay, let's hack it. Wait, no, wait, I got a better choice. Gun. I'm going to shoot it with my gun. Guys, ready for me to shoot this turret with a gun?
Cause Because gun wins every time.
Well, not every time. I mean, there's certain times where gun doesn't win. Oh, yeah, guys, look at all the alcohol in my system. I feel so good, yeah. Let's go drinking.
Surprised you haven't thrown up yet.
It's because of our clone biology. That's the other thing. Like, some people argue that we're technically a clone of Andrew Ryan, but the entire point is that Ryan's pissed at the woman that he goes to sleep with because she lost the baby. Not lost as in lost because of complications, but lost its location. Mm-hmm. She lost his son, so he's kind of pissed. And you know, you'd almost feel for him if it wasn't Andrew Ryan. You feel for him for other reasons. What? Oh, come on. Please. What? Really, game? Okay, please. Okay, thank you. Oh, thank you. Oh, that's something I can work with, actually. Yep. Okay, so I also would like to put out the invent machines, which lets you build guns and stuff. You can hack them. And the entire reason I think you can hack them is because basically Ryan is forcing people to pay, you know, excess amount of supplies to build stuff. I'm gonna build some more exploding buckshot because I can.
Well, things that go boom are always fun.
Oh, I'm already full up on exploding buckshot. So basically there's a bunch of just exploding buckshot lying on the ground there. Well,
that's
a
shame.
It's fine.
Does it disappear over time, or...?
Probably not. Maybe. We'll find out. Oh, hey, we've got another power to the people station, which lets us upgrade our weapons.
Because a lot of other games in there would usually do that, just to basically make sure the frames are consistent.
Probably will disappear if we leave the area.
Man, that's some income that's wasted then.
I mean, to be fair, we didn't spend money. We spent gasoline and stuff.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so for you to realize, I'm a hoarder on equipment. Like, hell. In, like, some of the, in, like, I think New Vegas in the third game, I would drag a lot of crap with me just so I can, just to save it for, like, the blueprints, or, I figured there might be some use for this stuff later. I just don't know where. So I'm just gonna hide it all in the house that I was given.
To be fair, that's what Novak is. It's your first house.
Mm-hmm.
There, wait, no, get back here. Where are you? Stop running from me. Oh, yeah, that's...
Yeah, your first house and also the one place in the ending that gets hit the hardest. Depending, no matter what you do.
Freeside?
No, Novak.
Novak doesn't get hit hard.
I remember in the prologue it did originally. Or in my version, anyway.
It depends on who you side with, depends on how hard it gets hit. It can get pretty hard, though, but... I think the hardest place to save is technically Freeside, because the best ending for Freeside is technically the one where you basically go independent, and even in that, it basically gets fucked by refugees so hard that it takes a few years for it to recover. If you go with the house side, house only incorporates the Elvis gang into Vegas. The other gangs are basically, you know, wiped out once he basically fully rebuilds Vegas.
I don't know, I remember actually, like, the Kings actually, if they stay in the Freeside, they actually do keep, like, everything under control.
If you go independent, yeah, they keep everything under control, but because of the surplus of, basically, the followers and other things, all the drug problems stay the same. It takes, you know, all the work you did to try and improve stuff doesn't help because you had to... All that basically just prepared them for, you know, oh, everything's going to be better as long as we don't have a bunch of refugees coming in. What happens after the dam? Yeah, the dam basically... Oh, yeah, and we can buy a new upgrade. So I think we're going... Oh, consumption. Reduce the
unfortunately, either
consumption
way, the followers are going to get swamped with refugees.
Yep. So, yeah, we got a new power to the people. I love these. I love the Fontaine futuristics. You stick gun in, gun comes out with upgrades that make it more deadly.
Actually, the description for it?
It's basically what it is. You don't pay for it. You just stick your gun in, and it comes out with more bullet parts on it that make it shoot better.
Right. Are we going with Orc's philosophy, then?
These things actually seem to be doing stuff, to be fair.
Where you add more parts to make DACA, to make more DACA.
There's just fires in the middle of this place. Oh, yeah. There's the gents' room. But can we go into the ladies? Can we? Yes, we can go into the ladies. We're going to go into the ladies' room.
Mm-hmm.
Why is there a turret in the freaking ladies' room?
Probably because you shouldn't be in there.
Shut up, Bill. I'll go where I want. I'm going to hack the turret in the ladies' room so it only shoots people that aren't me.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, here's why it's got the turret in there. It's full of liquid nitrogen. Someone was hiding their liquid nitrogen in here.
Because no one suspects somebody would speak into the ladies' room.
Except the fact that there's a bunch of women in here, and there was like the 3 episodes where we were only fighting women, which got really awkward for us. And we started making jokes about it. Is the game trying to say something? And then we find a group of statues in a weird pose. Yeah, we're leaving.
After we just steal some of the shit in here.
Where do we need to go now? Anyways, we went the wrong way entirely for a bit. We need to go to, I think, the Poseidon's thing? Yeah, we need to... Where do we need to go? What's our actual goal right now? Kill Martin Finnegan.
And, hey, Jib, you still with us?
Yeah.
Jib, we need to go kill a guy named Martin Finnegan. I need you to go find him.
Alright, I'll Google him.
I think he might have been joking. Or, I don't know.
Oh, my God. Oh, hi, Spider Slicer. Can you stop trying to murder us? Hello, ma'am. I'm just going to take a photo of you, if you don't mind.
Mm-hmm. Do you get a permit?
Well, she's an adult. She can consent. Ma'am, please come back. Oh, I see you up there. Can you please not crawl on the ceiling with your terrifying hook hands?
Actually, if you say, how long do you have to stay still to turn invisible?
Not very long, but once they notice me, they can keep following me because they know about the plasmid stuff, so they technically understand what I'm doing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so they understand that I'm just using the plasmid thing that lets me turn invisible. So they just know I'm standing still, because it can only let you... Yeah.
Okay, so the AI is smart enough to realize that, though.
I can see your breath.
You think you gotta finish me and hear your fruit?
What is the AI smart enough to realize?
It can... If it sees you and you go invisible, it still knows where you are.
So is that somebody hanging on the wall?
You can't come in for the cold.
Ah, yeah, you're already done too far.
Yeah, probably.
Ice everywhere.
Oh, hey, I just unfroze that guy. Now he's burning to death. Sir? Sir. Sir. Please stop panicking. You are not helping yourself. You are burning to... Okay, sir. I tried to help you, but then you attacked me. I'm sorry that I had to do that to you.
Does anyone know of stop, drop, and roll in this universe?
Probably. We can set trash cans on fire and set wheels on fire. Really, we can set most anything on fire. Let's just go burn things, because burning is fun. I heard it. I think there's a big daddy this way. But first up, let's... Sir, I think there's some other people over here that are frozen in ice. Let's go help them.
Is there any actual point to doing that, or...?
Yeah, if we go far enough this way, the guy we're over here to kill freezes a solid. And then he...
Well, I mean, like, unfriending other people.
Killing them.
Left me to freeze. You just got frozen.
Yeah, see, this guy freezes a solid once we get close enough. Basically, these guys are all just as crazy as... Yeah, it's scripted. You get frozen by him. He wants to basically turn you into a statue for his collection. But then we unfreeze. It's not really explained why, we just unfreeze.
The first time I played Bioshock, I don't remember the circumstances, but that's the only location I died at.
It's pretty easy not to die in this game, but I'm not trying to be particularly skillful at the game. Also, these people are attacking us despite being on fire.
Yeah, I don't remember what about that frozen room that killed me. Something about it that was like because I didn't have an item or something.
I'm pretty sure if you don't have the firepower, then you freeze to death, or you don't have the firepower equipped.
Yes. Now put the picture in the frame.
Oh wow, we accidentally killed the guy. We accidentally killed the guy we needed to kill that we came here to kill.
That was wow. By just setting the other people on fire?
Yeah. By entire accident, we murdered our target. We would be the best assassin now.
I feel like there's another movie or something where a person is mistaken to be an assassin or something, but only ends up accidentally killing most of those targets.
I'm remembering Slevin, which is a great movie that I want to do in the movie segments for the random cast with you guys, because Slevin is... The reason I love it is because it's got Bruce Willis in different part, and that's part of its plot, actually, is that this kid is assumed to be this person that owes these two mob bosses a shit ton of debt. That's the basic premise. Oh, you're this guy, but it's like, no, I'm his friend that came over for the week because he said he was in town. And, well, so the job is, basically these two mob bosses are both hiring him to assassinate people.
Uh-huh.
He gets mistaken. Oh, hey, there's a little girl here. Guys, there's a little girl. There's a little girl! We need to go get pictures. Come back. Please don't move. Oh, hey, it's one of the drill ones.
You know, because we've just been getting the ones with cannons.
Yeah, and we're just going to take a picture of this big daddy. Oh my god, wow, he's worth so much because we haven't got a picture of one of them before. Oh, we're out of ammo. Okay, well, let's murder him now. Oh, what? No, never mind. He's getting into a fight with some... No, oh, never mind, the splicer's attacking me. I'm sorry, Mr. Bubbles! I'm sorry! I'm sorry!
No, you're not.
Oh, right. You're right. I'm not sorry at all.
You murdered Mr. Bubbles.
He's not dead yet. Oh, God. Hi, Mr. Bubbles. That hurt. Now he's dead.
Don't run! We were just getting started!
Poor guy.
I didn't want to, but you know, he's worth money.
That guy's just fucking ballerining around you.
Oh, come on, really? More of you, little bat? Die! Die and leave me alone. I'm trying to help a little girl here.
Oh dear, Edgy, has it been noticed the splicers can actually take the little sisters away and...
They're not trying right now. So the answer is no, they don't do anything. Okay, where the heck... There you are. There, you're dead. You're dead. You're all dead. Mr. Bubbles is dead. And I am going to rescue this little girl now. Stop resisting. Stop resisting. Just let me tell you. It's for your own good.
Where do they run?
They don't run. They just kind of go, eh.
The little ones have never had anyone to look to, except to me.
Thank you.
And I am not much to speak of. You give them hope. And for this, I am grateful. I'll send something to demonstrate that gratitude.
Yeah. And Tendenbaum is sending us another gift because he saved enough little girls.
Mm-hmm. That way, yeah, you get an extra gift for saving
more of them? Well, every time you save three of them, you get a gift, which is why if you save all of them or kill all of them, it's the same result.
Mm-hmm.
Because the gift makes up the difference.
Ah, yeah. Again, even I've probably more or less said this one too many times probably in these recordings, but I never really see the point of going usually evil in most games.
I mean, evil can be fun, but you know, it has to be fun. This is literally murdering children. That's not fun. That's the thing that evil does well, is when it's fun to be evil because you can just do... Oh, hey, there's another Bubbles. Look, Mr. Bubbles is happy to see us now, Bill. This time he's not angry at us for some reason.
Because you murdered his brother.
Also, Sandra Cohen's killed a lot of people.
Uh-huh.
Also, he wants us...
And we're supposed to murder him, right?
Oh no, you don't have to murder Cohen at all. You can leave him alone.
Boy, so there's the option of killing or not killing him?
He shows up after you do the entirety of his quest. And you can basically just say, you know, ignore him and let him live. Or you can actually try and kill him. I think a Houdini splicer, basically, in difficulty, so he's pretty easy to kill if you want to. He may have more health than a normal Houdini, but yeah, otherwise he's not anything special. Wait, where's the... Big Daddy, where are you? Daddy! Daddy, I need to take a picture of you. Here.
You should probably see about getting that other, plasmid again.
Probably, but right now we need to actually go drop off this photo. Sandra asked us to do that, so... Right. The game's not lagging anymore, so I guess it was just time, basically. Don't you wanna take a walk with me? What the... Hey, look! Another little girl! And she came with a Big Daddy, too! Let's make sure we got the little girl as the focal point. No, it was the Big Daddy. Yeah, that works. Okay, I'll just have to kill a Big Daddy. Come on! I wasn't even aiming for the... What the heck hit me? Oh. Okay, let's change ammo out. Oh, Mr. Bubbles, please, don't make this any more ridiculous than it has to be. I'm just trying to murder you to save the little... Okay, Mr. Bubbles. Whoa. I just duped him. Oh, my. Mr. Oh, yeah, that's the thing. If he does the drill... Sorry, Mr. Bubbles! And now he's dead. And we're gonna rescue her, because we don't kill little girls, because we're not monsters. It's not like it's a difficult question or anything. And there's, yeah, only one little girl left in this area. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Now let's just go find the little girl generator. We need to go find that. And it will have money for us.
It's coming together. Yes.
And then Cohen gives us another gift. Seriously though, morbidly, this is a very pretty thing. He gives us. Oh yeah. Doubters. Yeah, Cohen is crazy as. Crazy as a fruit bar. And he's nutty as a nut bar. So, Jib, we were talking about Fate Stay Night earlier.
Do you know nothing about it.
Congratulations. There's not really a lot to know about it. It is a very... Why is there just a random splicer just in the middle of this back alley area? Wow, my own turret's hit me.
Alright, I got ice cream.
Nice.
I can control myself! I can't!
Okay, where... Oh, there's a little sister thing. Are we in the right area? Where am I on the map? Am I in the...
Hey, don't run!
Okay. Oh boy, what a floor show every night.
You got no friends here.
That guy just told us we don't have any friends here, guys. Technically, he is right. We have no friends here. We don't live here, so we have no friends. Still kind of rude. Sir, I hate to tell you this. Just because we don't have any friends doesn't mean you should insult us. Oh, hey, look, the little sister's up to us a gift. And it's hypnotized Big Daddy, too.
Mm-hmm. Well, except for you do have friends in little, well, I'm just gonna stop there.
In little girls, yes. Our friends are little girls.
That just sounds wrong now.
Hey, Bill. Bill, I wanna tell you something. Our friends are little girls. And we got telekinesis back.
Throw objects at foes. You can even catch grenades and throw them back.
And now we can evolve ourselves more. I'm going to get us some combat tonics. So we're... You made a... I'm going to take the wrench lurker because that lets us do the stealth stuff better. There we go. We'll put that in. Then we're going to get an engineering tonic because we have the points for it. Select your engineering tonic. And we're going to get a physical tonic because we can. We almost have all the physical tonics we can get. got so many. Ooh. And we get Eve Saver too. And we can also make it so vending machines are somehow cheaper. Oh wait, that's a. Oh, that's a. Oh, that's good. We'll take that. There we go. Well, we don't want to use. Oh yeah, we do take fall damage in this game. Guys, we take fall damage. Did you know that? I know, we take fall damage.
That's new.
Things. I didn't think we'd take fall damage, but yeah, we do. Fall damage makes sense in some games, though, to be fair. Other games,
you're
like,
then again,
why?
You do see how high up you were falling from.
True, yeah, I'm not saying there's anything wrong with it. I'm just saying, some games you go, why do I take fall damage? Other games are like, okay, that makes sense. Please tell me, did you... Guys, the last little girl we've been looking for! Oh wait, there's a bunch of people here trying to murder us. Let's murder them first, then we'll kill the big daddy and help the little girl. Some woman's hitting on us, guys. There you are. Hello, sir. Sir. You should have been looking behind you. Did you not expect me to come up with you under the gun in my hand? I mean, you've all been trying to murder me. Do they not understand that they're trying to murder me? Oh, hey, look. Ryan Stable Boy. Oh yeah, I love that. That's an extra interesting thing, is that basically Cohen is Ryan's man to make things look much better than they actually are. Ow. Was that it? That was their big thing? They're just gonna attack. Okay.
They're all on fire.
Okay, game, I need to... Game? Okay, I can't jump out. So what am I supposed to do, game? Game? There we go. Okay. We got a Tommy gun, by the way, Jib. You know, your favorite gun, the Tommy gun. The Chicago typewriter. You murdered my kittens! By the way, we just murdered this man's kitten, despite the fact that those were people. So I guess we killed some cats when we were in there, somehow. Despite those being people.
Well, they were wearing cat masks, so fair enough. I guess it counts.
Anyways, a little girl is basically just right now. Mr. Bubbles! Mr. Bubbles, please! I just want the girl! I just want the girl, Mr. Bubbles! Stop making this different! Oh god, he is fast! Mr. Bubbles! Don't make this different! Oh. By the way, I'd like to point out that technically it is a drill, but it's also a blade weapon. Like, it's a nightmare tool, basically. And we rescue her. And we're good. We save somebody. You see, I don't like killing the big daddies, but they're the only way to get upgrade points. So, at the same time, we kind of have to. You're welcome. Go run to your hole now. Go be safe. We got napalm, guys. We've been here. So this is where. Oh, what's. Oh, Pharaoh's Fortune Casino. By the way, yeah, there's a casino in Rapture. Would you go to a casino in a Randian society, Bill?
I don't know. Usually the first law I remember in a casino is the house always wins. You're saying, anyway.
And in a Randian society where every place is already a casino and the house always wins as long as you pay them. How do you feel about an actual casino?
How would one even work in a...
Not well. Also, that's an interesting thing. Everyone thought Fontaine was killed.
Like, the players or the people?
No, like, everyone in Rapture thought Fontaine got killed, like he went down John Wayne style.
Mm-hmm.
Also, there's a security camera in there. We're gonna kill it, though. Dang it, I was hoping it would drop some film. Also, there's a bunch of cigars here. Cigars of every type. And a bunch of money, too. And some anti-personnel pistol rounds. Wonder what this guy... Was this guy gonna try and smoke all this, I guess?
Possibly.
Oh, and six.
That or maybe it was a shop.
Well, obviously it was a shop at some point. Oh, hey, there's another big daddy around. Where is he?
Or maybe he's gonna make the new currency out of cigars.
And this is basically where we learn Andrew Ryan had a lady friend.
Mm-hmm.
Because we start hallucinating. I don't know why we would be hallucinating. I say after I chug 6 bottles of booze. And then hop up on the stage where the hooker was. I'm sorry, dancer. Here's some money.
I thought you had forgotten about poor Jasmine. But I am so
yes,
glad you did.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry, Mr. Ryan, I didn't know. I
didn't know Fontaine had something to do with it. What are you doing?
No.
More flashbacks.
So Fontaine stole Ryan's kid, a Chaos, and that's the basic part of the thing with those aren't our parents, and Ryan has her killed because he's kind of angry. Also, our mother, the only thing she had on her was some fine gin. And there's a pipe in here, and there's a thing about the pregnancy.
Mm-hmm.
No, I wasn't being careful. Gonna know I sold the. Mr. Ryan's gonna be so mad at me.
Yeah. So, in other news, yeah. They had her get pregnant for this entire plan. Yes. Yeah. Maybe I'll just, you know, do something. Man, this guy sounds so intimidating.
Who does he think he is?
Is he running away from me? Yeah, he is. He's just running away from me. Of course he is. Oh, and hey.
He has fire in his hand. Well, that's one of the grenaders.
He's one of the grenaders.
And it just doesn't make me miss Half-Life.
Yeah.
And once again, I have that one question. When is episode 3 coming out, Gabe? As you push in another year forward.
He's not pushing it, they weren't making it.
And I just remember that was the joke that was put up on the Steam forums. If anybody kept asking, he was going to push it up another year, but I think they've officially given up on it.
Yeah, they gave up on it a long time ago, and they mentioned that in like 2006 here. Something that they weren't actually working on it. They hadn't been. Because the entire point of 2 was to basically be a tech demo about how to do all these really cool and important things with shooters. 2 was a tech demo showing us all the cool things that you can do with a shooter with physics engines and all these other things. Like turning it into the thing that you can use physics to inflict damage to an enemy, etc. And Elite hates the game because it is that. And Elite doesn't seem to get that. He's like, I want more story, and I want, and I know it's not gonna get completed. Wah, it's not good enough because of these things. Like, you do realize the entire point of it was to be all these things because it wasn't about making a game, it was about...
Well, I guess they were more showing off their engine, right?
Yeah, they were 1, showing off their engine, 2, showing off what you can do with a shooter. Because they were trying to, you know, make people be creative with their mechanics. It wasn't about, you know...
Mm-hmm.
Oh, there he is, sir.
I was trying to think about it. How many different other games did use the Source Engine?
I mean, the Source Engine, even if it's not being used a lot, has been used a lot, and was used a lot because it was super influential.
I guess I'm also just kind of wishing for another game of Gravity Gun.
I mean, there's plenty of games with the gravity. Oh my god, I need more ammo for my goddamn camera. We burned out all over. There we go, film, finally. I'm gonna buy a bunch of film. There we go, 90 film should be enough.
Oh yeah. I guess we're not in a digital camera era.
Yep. To be fair, some digital camera games have the cameras have a battery life.
Mm-hmm.
Like, yeah, that's a thing. Oh, okay, let's get a good picture. Silas Cobb.
I know.
Lying
I know
dead
some games
the
will just
ground as a corpse.
I know some games will just let you use the or use your memory card as the camera limit.
Yep, that's another one. That's actually how it works in Dark Cloud. I'm looking for some big daddies to take some photos of.
Mm-hmm. I don't know. But then again, like, I don't know, I did actually enjoy, like, the Half-Life game, or Half-Life 2 quite a bit, you know, if it was a tech demo.
Eh, call me later. Wee-wee-wee.
Okay.
You had enough, Jib?
We're about to finish up, anyways. We're at a good point to finish up once we put this photo up.
Mm-hmm.
Where is this gosh dang Big Daddy?
Coffee break?
No, they're all wearing masks, but I just find it funny that the spiders are wearing bunny-like ones. And they're kicking like bunnies!
Yeah, they're fighting like bunnies. Their range attack is actually to throw the hooks they have on their hands, somehow. Speaking of which, I am literally just throwing bees at them, because bees, my god.
Oh dear. Actually, it's funny, because it looks like the bees are also stinging your hands when you got the, when you're doing the bee thing. I know, I actually remember when I was used to playing like the Legend of Zelda Link to the Past, and whenever I ended up catching a bee.
Temperament. The Earth is so close now.
The labor. Yeah, so he starts apologizing and saying, I'm sorry about putting that out first.
What was he mad at you again for?
He's just mad at everyone because he thinks everyone's judging him because Rapture's going to shit. And he thinks everyone blames him.
And also he's a artist.
Yeah. Because
artists are always flaky.
I mean, that's kind of the joke, is that he's flaky because he's an artist. To be fair, he's flaky in part because he is an artist, in part because he doesn't... Oh, hey, there's a spider slicer.
Oh, we gave you a present.
Yeah. Basically, it's an apology for trying to murder you present.
The best kind.
I think that's it for the spider spicers, too. Let's see. We'll determine now, because there's 5 research levels. There's plus 1, plus 2, plus 3 damage. Okay, and if the game would just load, we'll see. Plus 3 damage. We're done with spider slicers. No, we're not, actually.
So we can just kill them. Oh.
Yeah, some of the damage levels just increase our ability to kill.
Uh-huh.
So they also scream when you cover them in bees, it turns out. People don't like being covered in bees. I don't get why. They're just bees.
Know. How about we ask Nicolas Cage?
Not the bees! No, sorry, Nick. We gotta cover you with more bees now. We'll see you in a bit, audience. Bye-bye.